A man is dead after a Jacksonville sheriff's officer opened fire on him while he was shooting into a car. Police say the suspect was shooting at someone sitting in the back seat when the officer arrived. The scene is shutting down Main Street near Andrew Jackson High School in Brentwood for hours this evening. That's where we find On Your Side's Zach Wilcox. And Zach, that shooting happened in the middle of the street in the middle of the day.
Yeah, Riley, Main Street was shut down for probably about 4.5 hours. As you mentioned, they finally got open up around 8:30. While it was shut down, we talked with a witness who was shopping at the convenience store here near Andrew Jackson High School. He came out, and that's when he saw and heard the gunshots. And his first instinct was to drop to the ground right where I'm standing to try and avoid any stray bullets coming his way. And it wasn't until after the sounds of gunfire ended that he learned it was actually an officer-involved shooting.
I always describe it as putting a piece of puzzle together, right? You get pieces all over the place down there.
JSO Director Mark Romano says the pieces the department has put together so far tell them three people in a car got in an argument when they stopped at a red light on Main Street. One man ran from the passenger side, while the driver got out and started firing a gun back into the car with someone sitting in the back seat. Before anyone could call 911, JSO was already there.
Our police officer who was on duty just left another call for service. Officer Brian Roan pulled up, saw an individual shooting into a vehicle. He stepped out of his vehicle, shot multiple times at the suspect, striking him.
Romano says that suspect died at the hospital. The person in the back seat went to the hospital for non-life-threatening injuries and didn't have any gunshot wounds. Officer Roan has been with JSO for 16 years and has never had to shoot someone before.
You can imagine the adrenaline rush that he had when he saw that. Number one. Number two, he's probably thinking in his mind, I don't believe what I'm seeing.
First Coast News crime and safety expert Ken Jefferson says deadly force was an appropriate response to the situation.
You don't have time to try to order him to drop a gun because he's already fired that weapon. Who's to say that he won't turn on you and try to shoot you with it as well?
Romano says there were lots of witnesses to interview to help figure out what led up to the guns being drawn in the first place, but one big piece is still missing.
And I would stress that one of the big pieces of the puzzle is that person that fled that vehicle.
So JSO hoping that that person who ran will come in and give them more information so they can finish piecing this together. And JSO will do an internal investigation into Officer Roan's decision to fire his weapon, as well as the state attorney's office was out here. They'll do their own investigation as well. In Brentwood, Zach Wilcox, First Coast News, On Your Side.